Welcome to this tutorial on how you do the boutique ribbon. And this was sent to me by Red Heart. I was sent two skeins of it. Here's one I've already crocheted, which is very pretty. So yeah, that's it. So I'm going to show you how to do this. Make this a little bigger. Move my other stuff. My scissors. Okay. And we're using the L hook. Let me move all that out the way so it doesn't focus on that. Don't focus on that. Okay? So, let's remove the band off. I'm going to open it up. Ooh. I can see where I can get tangled. And I didn't do this when I did the first one, but I'm doing it this time. I learned my lesson. So now we want to cut off all these little strings here. Okay. This one's kind of tied up here. So there's the end and there's the end there. So keeping the eye on the end. So I'm looking for all the little strings. So I want to cut off the instructions here too. Let's find any more strings here. I have a string here. Okay. Anywhere else? Yeah. Right here. We have a string over here. Okay. I think that's all the strings. So now we're gonna roll it up. Get it a little untwisted here. I usually don't use this end right here because the way it looks. So, but I'm gonna use it. So we're just gonna roll it up. I think I'm gonna start out here on the end. So I'm just gonna roll it up on itself. So it's flat, like so. Just keep going, making sure not to twist it. This, I wish I would have did this for the first one, because it was a pain. Okay. So we're just gonna roll it up. So you're just gonna keep doing this. And then you wanna, once you get to the top of it, roll it back down, going back the other way. Then you can get a little faster with it. Once you get into the end, go back upward. I hope you guys can see this okay. I'm just rolling it, rolling on the river, rolling on the river. Okay, never mind that. Okay. Just kind of twist it up here. And just keep doing that until you get to the end. So I'm going to keep rolling. And remember, you can use a rolling pin or a cylinder. I think using a paper towel roll, empty paper towel roll, will work best. Okay, so I'm just going to keep going, and I'll meet you when I'm done. Okay, so I got my roll here, and you see how the ends look all raggedy? Usually I don't use that part, but I am this time around. I'm so glad I did the paper towel roll this time, because when I did the other one, it was a twisted mess. I mean a twisted mess, okay? So, with your L hook, okay, you're going to start here. I'm going to go this way. So I can just roll it this way. This is the way I'm going to go. So I'm going to miss this part right here, and I'm just going to start where it looks really nice right here. Okay? Let me zoom it in a little bit more. Okay, so I'm going to stick in my hook, and I'm going to do it just like my previous video of using a sachet yarn. Okay? So I'm going to stick through hook there. I'm going to skip one. Put the other loop on there, like so. And then I'm going to skip one, put the other loop on, and I'm going to pull it through the first two loops. One and two. That's one. See it? Now I'm going to roll it out. Skip one, put the next one on the hook. Skip one, put the next one on the hook, and pull it through the first two. One and two. That's two. Roll it out a little bit more. Oh, I love this roll. I love the roll. So, okay, that was two. So you're going to skip one, put the next one on there. You're going to skip another one. Skip another one here. Put the next one on and pull it through the next two. That's three. We're going to do five, okay? So let's roll it back out. Skip one, put one on the hook. Skip one, put one on the hook. And pull it through the first. Okay, that's four. All right, roll it out. Skip one, put one on the hook. Skip one, put one on the hook. Four, five. Okay, so we have a total of five single crochets. So now we're gonna skip one. Skip one and put one on the hook for a chain one. So you're going to chain one and then turn it around. Okay? And so let me show you how I can find my stitches. I look at the spaces here. Here's one. Let me see if I can get a little bit closer. I look at the spaces here. Here's one. Here's two. Here's three. Here's four. And then the last one, five, okay? So you have to look at it very good. So I already chained one. Oops, get my hook ready. So I already chained one. You're still gonna be skipping a loop and pulling through, okay? So I wanna go through the first stitch, which is here. I skipped one, put one on the hook. Pull it through, skip one, put the next one on the hook, you roll it out, and pull it through. That's one. To go through the next stitch, which is here, right here. So I'm going to stick my hook through, and I skip the loop, put one on it, pull it up. Skip a loop, pull through the next one, and that is the next one. Okay, it's two. Go through our next one. We just went through this one, so we're going through this one here. So stick through, skip a loop, pull up, skip a loop. Pull through. It's three. Skip a loop. Pull up. Skip a loop. Pull through. Four. And then the last here, you kind of have to force it through. make sure it's going through both loops. Get through there. Okay. Skip a loop. Pull through. Skip a loop. Pull it through the two. Then skip a loop. And chain one. And roll out. And then turn your work around. And so you really have to eyeball it to see where you are. As you can see how the ruffles overlap each other. So I have one here, one here, one, three, four, and then the last one here, five. Okay? So it's really hard to see, but maybe I can zoom in some more. In. And be right in the middle right here. Okay, so I'm going through, pull up, skip a loop, pull through. That's one. Move over to next loop, through, pull up, skip one, pull through. Move over the next loop, roll it out right here. Pull through, skip, and pull through. Okay. Move over to the next loop, which is here, for four. Pull up, wrap around. Pull through. And the last one. Go through. Pull up. Wrap around. Pull through, through. Skip one for a chain one. Turn your work around. So once again, I'll show you where my stitches are. If you can see, I'll put my hook down. Well, I'll just put it to the side. So I'm got stitch here. That's one, two, three, four, and then five. See? And so you just want to keep doing that all the way around. And roll out as you need it. Boy, the paper towel roll sure is helpful. And then the last one here. And skip one and chain one. And so that's how it is. I hope that wasn't too hard. I know it's kind of difficult to show in camera, but yeah, that's how I crocheted this one. And if you go through it, you can see right here. You see my stitches? If you lift up the ruffles, you can see the stitches. Each ruffle. Okay? So I hope this was helpful. I really do. Two, three, four, and the last one. 5, then chain 1. Round. One. Two. Three. Four. Thank you.